Welcome back to the Barbecue Lab. My name is David Gafford, and today we're going to take an in-depth look at the Solo Stove Grill. We'll go through the pros and cons, show you some of the cooks that we've done on it, and help you decide if this is the right grill for your backyard. Before we get into the review, make sure you stick with us until the end of the video where you can learn how you can enter to win a Sasquatch Burger Press. It's easy to enter, and more on that in a bit, but back to the Solo Stove Grill. We built an outdoor kitchen this year, and in that space we have two Kamado shelves that we use for testing different grills. We put the Solo Stove Grill into one of those spaces, and we've been using it all summer as our primary charcoal grill. We've done quite a few cooks on the grill, and we're ready to walk you through our experience with it. My wife bought me the Yukon Fire Pit from Solo Stove, and it's changed the way that we entertain and utilize the fire pit on our new patio. After enjoying the Yukon so much, we knew that we wanted to try out the grill, and that's what we dedicated our summer grilling to. Let's start with what comes in the box. There's the Solo Stove Grill Unit, a PVC cover to keep the rain and water out when not in use, a carrying bag for when you want to take this with you to the campsite or out on the trail, a set of grill tools, including a spatula, a grill fork, and a set of grill tongs, a 4-pound bag of charcoal, and a set of 4 fire starters to get you going on your first cook. There's also a lid for the grill with a nice heat-resistant handle, and it also comes with a 13-inch short stand. The grill measures 21.5 inches wide, and the cooking surface utilizes 21 inches of the available space. With the lid on the grill, it stands at 29.5 inches tall, and without the lid, the grill is 22 inches high with the short stand. When it comes to assembling this grill, all of the work is in putting together the stand. It takes about 5 minutes to assemble, and all the tools you need are included in the box. It probably takes longer to take each piece out of the plastic that it's shipped in than it does to finish the rest of the assembly. The grill is constructed of 304 stainless steel. The grill itself is stainless, the grates are stainless, the ash pan and the charcoal grate are both stainless, the tools are stainless. It's probably easier to talk about the parts that aren't stainless, so let's do that. The lid on the grill is made of enameled porcelain. The grill shelter, or cover for those new to the Solo Stove naming system, is made of PVC, and the carry case is made of what feels like a heavy canvas material. Now let's talk about the grates for a minute. The grates are made of stainless steel, and they're pretty heavy in comparison to many other grates on the market for grills of this size. I really like that the grates have a swivel up hinge built into each side of the grate. It allows for easy replenishing of charcoal or throwing in a piece of wood to add some smoke to the cook. The grates are easy to swivel around using the handles attached to each side, and it makes it handy when you are using the grill in a confined space like we are here. The grill itself is double-walled like you might see in their line of fire pits. The primary differences between the fire pits and the grill is that there's no air circulation to the top of the unit to give out a secondary burn. The air that comes into the grill is circulated down below the ash pan. Solo Stove has a nifty diagram on their website showing how the airflow works on this grill, and it's quite different from their fire pit design. The grill is also much more shallow than the fire pits as well, so to use this as a fire pit, you'd need much shorter logs than you'd usually have. Could you build a fire in this grill and use it as a fire pit? I mean, there's nothing to stop you from doing that, but their fire pits are less expensive than the grill for most sizes, and they're meant to do just that, so maybe just go with a fire pit if that's what you really want. One of the things that Solo Stove talks about when it comes to this grill is the convection cooking feature. There's no lower air control vent on this grill like you might find on a comparable Weber kettle or PK360. On those grills, you control just how much air comes in the bottom to have control over the heat of the grill. This grill is designed to run between 400 and 500 degrees all the time, so no air control vent means that this grill is a grill and not a smoker. Now, I'm sure that some of you are going to be bummed out that this grill isn't as versatile as a Weber kettle, and that's okay. I'll just come out and say that this probably isn't the grill for you if smoking is something that you want to do with the one grill you're going to buy. Solo Stove didn't make this grill to be versatile. They designed it to do one thing the best that it could, and that's grill in the 500 degree range. I've grilled all kinds of meals on this cooker, and it really did best when I let it stay in its lane. Burgers are amazing on this grill. You can get the sear marks that you want to impress family and friends without fussing with airflow and perfect amounts of charcoal. Hot dogs are easier than easy and come away with a stronger charcoal and smoke flavor than I get on the Kamado grills that we have here at the lab. I even tried to cook with chicken wings where I banked my coals to one side and cooked them indirectly for a bit before spreading things out and finishing them off over direct heat. There is some ability to cook indirectly on this grill, but it's all in how you place the coals under the grate that will allow more cooking versatility. The bottom of the grill is notched all around, so it won't move on the stand once set in place. So, how do you light this grill? The first time around, it makes sense to use the 4-pound charcoal pack and the package of 4 fire starters to fire it up. Just pile the entire contents of the charcoal package into the center of the grill and place fire starters in an X pattern around the edge of the pile. I always like to make sure that I have coals sitting above each fire starter to catch as the flame takes off, so a little bit of manual adjustment can mean the difference between taking 10 minutes and 30 minutes to get your fire going. Solo Stove advertises that you can have this grill up and running in 15 minutes. I suppose that can be true, but using the provided bag of coals and 4 lighter cubes, you're going to have a tough go to hit that mark. To get all of the coals lit and spread across the bottom of the grill for even heating, I'd plan on more around 30 minutes or more if you're going to be using fire starter bundles. After you've tried lighting with starter cubes, you might want to consider upgrading your fire starting equipment. We personally love the Loof lighter to start our charcoal fires, and we can have the grill up and running in 60 seconds. If that's still too slow for you, then there's always the grill gun. With this guy, you can have your fire up and going in about 30 seconds. Now, there's also the age-old question of which fuel to use. Is lump charcoal or traditional charcoal briquettes better in this grill? Well, both of them work just fine, but you'll find that there's a flavor difference depending on the brand and the charcoal type. I've cooked on this grill with Rockwood Lump Charcoal, Masterbuilt Lump Charcoal, Kingsford Professional Briquettes, Royal Oak Briquettes, and Fogo Super Premium Lump Charcoal, and there's a subtle flavor difference that we notice between the brands. I will also say that we really enjoyed the 4 pounds of charcoal briquettes that came with the grill, as that seemed like really, really nice charcoal briquettes. The flavor of that was fantastic. And so if you're going to be ordering this grill, you might want to pick up a couple extra packs of that because that was really, really good charcoal. Now, as far as longevity, 4 pounds of charcoal briquettes will burn for about 45 minutes at the 400 to 500 degree mark. The air intake is configured so that charcoal is meant to burn hot, which means that it's not going to be around for hours. The amount of air allowed in continuously throughout the cook means high grilling temps, and charcoal will just burn out. The longest we've been able to grill on this unit with 4 pounds of charcoal was a little over an hour, and that was with charcoal briquettes and keeping the lid on as much as possible throughout the cook. Solo Stove has a lifetime warranty against manufacturing defects on this unit, and if you follow the company in any of the groups online that gather around Solo Stove discussions and products, the company has a stellar reputation when it comes to honoring their warranty and coming through for their customer. When it comes to cleaning the Solo Stove grill, people always want to know how easy it is when you're cooking with charcoal. Many charcoal grills aren't fun to clean, but I love the way that Solo Stove has engineered this grill with cleanup in mind. To clean it out, just take off the grill grate and then shake off the charcoal grate if there's anything left from the previous cook. All you do is just lift out the ash pan and take it wherever you'd like to dump your ash. We like to put it in our garden to prep the soil for next season. Just put the pan back in when you're done, and that's it. So what's this grill good at? To state the obvious, this grill excels at grilling cuts of meat between 400 and 500 degrees. It's what it's built to do, and it does it well. If searing is your thing, this grill has you covered as well. You can get a mean crust on a steak cooking directly over charcoal running 500 degrees. The char on the outside of protein that you can get from this grill is very nice, and you won't be disappointed if that's one of the things that you're looking for. On the lid, we really like the latch or clip that allows it to affix itself to the side of the grill. The fit of the lid is nice and tight, but if you're rolling a bunch of smoke, you'll still see it leaking out between the grill and the lid since it's not latched down in any way. I also really liked that the grill grate has the two folding sections. I'll use these for longer grilling sessions when I just need to throw a few handfuls of coal on the fire to extend a cook, or for dropping chunks of wood on the fire to get a deeper smoke flavor. One of the things that this grill is really good at is turning heads when people come over. We've had 15 to 20 people over each week for the last 6 months, and more than I can remember have asked about the Solo Stove grill. We have a ton of grills out here at the Barbecue Lab, yet people always want to talk about the Solo Stove and how it differs from their fire pits. So if you want your neighbors and guests to talk about your grill, this is one that gets them going. Now, if you're not using this grill in an outdoor kitchen environment like we are, and you're thinking about taking this grill on the road, the carrying case is a nice plus. The grill weighs just shy of 40 pounds, so it's definitely portable, but it's even better when you carry the grill with two people, which the carry case allows for. Just give each person one of the handles, and it's a breeze to carry down to the campsite. The legs to the grill do not fold, so they need to be carried down separately, but they are sturdy, and that's what I'm looking for in a grill base. Let's also take a second to talk about what this grill isn't great for. If you're wanting a grill that will both smoke meat and grill food, then this isn't the right grill for you. Smoking meat needs control of both the air intake and the air exhaust, and this grill only has control over the air leaving the pit, not coming in. You can get more smoke flavor by adding wood chunks to the coals, but it's by no means a low and slow smoker grill. Another thing that's more difficult on this grill is indirect cooking. If you're used to banking the coals to one side of the grill and putting the meat on the other side to indirect cook low and slow, you can kinda do that on the Solo Stove grill, but it's really not meant for that. You can bank the coals to the side, but it's still going to run hot even on an indirect cook, which mostly defeats the purpose of this method of cooking. If you're looking to have absolute control over the temperature of your grill, this won't be a good fit. It's built to run 400 to 500 degrees Fahrenheit, and temperature control isn't something that you have much control over. You can add more charcoal or put less charcoal, close the air vent or open the air vent fully, but that's pretty much all the control you'll have over the temperature of this grill. The grill tools that come with this package are pretty good. They're not up to the standards of the fire pit tools that they've put out, but that's not to say that these tools aren't good. They're just not rock star level good like their s'more sticks or their wood tongs. Those tools are easily going to be passed down to my kids when they check me into the assisted living facility. Solo Stove also has a new cooking system that they've released for fire pits as well, and many people are asking us what we think about the two cooking methods. We haven't yet cooked on the new cooking system, but we hope to one day in the future, and you know we'll report back about it when we do. So here are our overall thoughts on the Solo Stove grill. The Solo Stove grill is a perfect grill for people who want the head-turning look of a Solo Stove fire pit in grill form. It's easily one of the first grills that people want to know about when they visit here at the lab, and it's incredibly easy to operate. If you want the ease of a gas grill but the flavor of charcoal, then this is worth looking into. It's by far the easiest charcoal grill I've used because there's no meddling with air intake and fire management. It's quite simply a grilling machine that sears meat and veggies without needing to be a pitmaster who understands airflow. If that sounds like you, then give this beauty a look. If the height of the short stand isn't a good fit for your use, you can easily pick up a tall stand through the Solo Stove website for 7 more inches of cooking height. Because of our outdoor kitchen setup with our Kamado drawers, the short stand has worked all right for us. I can see why the short stand would be ideal for portability, but for anyone using this charcoal grill in their backyard, the taller stand would certainly be preferred for my use. Right now, the Solo Stove Grill is on sale for the lowest price of the year. If you click the link in the description below, you'll not only get the lowest price of the year, but you'll also be supporting our channel, and it doesn't cost you a penny more. Now, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, there's no time like right now, since only subscribers can enter to win the giveaway that we're having. We're giving away a Sasquatch Burger Press to a lucky winner who subscribed to the channel, gives this video a thumbs up, and leaves us a comment below. We'll pick a winner from the comments right before we publish our next video, so there's only a few days left to enter. So subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, and leave a comment below letting us know what your next piece of barbecue gear is going to be that you add to your collection. It could be a grill, or a smoker, a thermometer, or a knife, anything that you have your eye on this holiday season that you want to add to your collection. I'm David from the Barbecue Lab, and I want to say thank you for taking the time to hang out with us. Before we go, the winner of the Sasquatch Burger Press from our last video on the Pillar Barrel Smoker is RJ Sewell. RJ commented that he liked the removable rack system that the Pillar had and how you didn't have to fight with the lid to get it closed like you often have to do on a Kamado-style cooker. So congratulations, RJ. Send us an email at info@thebarbecuelab.com with your mailing address and we'll get that right out to you. So, this could be you next video. Drop that comment down below with the next piece of outdoor cooking gear you're thinking of buying, and you're entered. And I can't wait to see you next time.